In today's daily dose of math, we're looking at dartboard probability. This is example 3. Remember, all darts hit the dartboard. We are not trying to calculate a probability where some of the darts could land outside because we just do not have enough information. Here we have a dartboard that is shaped like a large trapezoid with a big base of 110, a small base of 70, and a height of 50. This is in centimeters. Inside it, we have a shaded rectangle with a length of 60 and a width of 30, and inside that we have an unshaded rectangle with a length of 20 and a width of 10. I've gone ahead and done the area formulas ahead of time, and we can see that the areas are 4,500, 1,800, and 200 centimeters squared, respectively. Now, the thing that makes students have a problem with this type of question is that before they have this work done, it seems like too much information and they panic. But the students know how to find these areas, and they need to just set about finding the areas because you know you need them in order to do favorable over total to find the answer. And I think all students who are facing a question like this have been given plenty of examples in a textbook or by a teacher and the opportunity to practice them. So there's no reason to panic. The dart hitting the shaded area is going to be the area of the shaded larger rectangle minus the area of the smaller rectangle, because the smaller one is not shaded. So we have 1800 minus 200 as our favorable. Our total is the area of the trapezoid, which is 4500. When we divide and simplify, we get 0.3556 in decimal form. We multiply by 100, and that equals approximately 35.6%. This time, when I find the area of the unshaded region, I'm just going straight to my shortcut. The unshaded region, the total of these two unshaded regions, has to be the complement of the shaded region. Therefore, unshaded and shaded have to add up to 100%. So my shortcut is to take 100%, subtract the probability of hitting the shaded region, and therefore the probability of hitting the unshaded region is 64.4%. There's no reason to panic. Do your area formulas and apply favorable over total, and you will be able to calculate any probability in any dartboard style problem. This is today's Daily Dose of Math. Don't forget to like this video, and if you're not subscribed yet, click on the subscribe button.